All right, if you're watching this, you probably know that X has been blowing up recently. His latest biggest success was he was featured on the XXL Freshman list, but X has always had like a cult-like fan base since the beginning.
If you're gonna be a fan, it's different than being someone that supports me.
Okay.
Because if you're a fan, that means you abide by everything that I believe in and that you support what I do to the fullest extent. Okay. If you support me, you're just like, oh, I see that nigga, he's grinding, you feel me? He's doing his thing.
Right.
And I'm going to support from this distance. But a fan is someone that, like, I feel like you have to be a core fan. Like, I have a cult fan base. I don't have, like, a weak-ass fan base. Like,
right.
I speak to my fans. I help my fans.
But when he got locked up, his fans seemed to multiply like crazy. His fan base kept on getting bigger and bigger the longer he stayed inside jail. And big names like ASAP Rocky and countless others were rooting for him to get out.
Mommy don't want me no more. She kicked me out of my room. Yeah, that shit hard, nigga. Fuck yeah. Free my nigga XXX. I can't wait till you come home. Fuck is you talking about? He the hardest nigga in Florida. I said it. So what? You don't like it? Suck my dick.
And amazingly, at this time, he only had a handful of SoundCloud songs and no music videos. His music was like no other person out. His versatility and his raw passion when rapping or singing is clear and cannot be mimicked. He is so versatile. Later, he released a song called Garrett's Revenge, which is a country song type of vibe. And X's fanbase actually rocked with it and still enjoyed the song. And I think no other rapper out there could pull this off as good as X did. I can only imagine someone like 21 Savage trying to pull a move like this and try to put out a country vibe type of song. And I can see his fanbase reacting a whole different way than how X's fanbase did.
I've dug two graves for us, my dear. Can't pretend that I was perfect living you in fear. Oh man, what a world, the things I hear.
And now you guys know a little bit more about X. We're gonna get straight into this top 5 things you didn't know about him. If you guys are familiar with X, you definitely know who Ski Mask the Slump God is. He's one of X's closest friends. Some of my favorite songs are with him and X on the same track. This song right here called Freddy vs. Jason, it's a flawless track where they switch every single bar.
Bitch, your mask with the pack, no trap laws.
Menace and Venice, turn your bitch up into a lost cause.
Beauty and the Beast for the clip, be cautious, caution. Murder the pussy, city floss.
Oh shit, I leave him corpses, a metamorphism, fancy. Lodge your head in the window of portions.
Core listening to courses, got an abortion. Slide in the pussy with Ritalin and a...
Did you guys know that X is the one that pushed Ski Mask the Slump God to start rapping? And they met in a juvenile jail in 2012. X had some experience rapping before. He was sent to juvenile detention and talked to Ski about his ambitions of making songs. And this had a huge influence of Ski Mask start rapping with X, and they both made countless songs together. And most of X's interviews, Ski Mask can be seen right next to X. The No Jumper interview, he was the one in the bright blue Adidas sweater, and right now has almost like 4 million views, which is insane.
Coolest podcast in the world. And today we're here with
XXXTentacion.
See, I'm making you say your own name because I've been looking at it online.
And in the interview on Elevator, which also has almost 1 million views, he can be seen there too.
My name is XXX.
My name is Ski Mask the Slump
God. I have a skinny dick.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You're watching Elevator.
This your man's. This your man's.
She grab on my dick like a handle. Hey, little bitch, I got on Jesus sandal.
And now we're on the fourth fact about X. If you guys didn't know, X actually dropped out of high school in the 10th grade to pursue what he wanted to do in life at the time. He wanted to do is become a UFC fighter, become a football player, or become a successful rapper. Those are the three things that he wanted to do with his life at the time. And he believed that the school was actually distracting him to where he wanted to be. So he actually dropped out. Worked out for the better because look where he is right now. He's one of hip-hop's fastest growing rappers. His fan base is only getting bigger and bigger, but he does not hate school. He actually supports people going to school unless their career path doesn't require it. This is what he's had to say on like the whole entire school situation.
What do you think about going to college or university? If you want to be a doctor, if you want to be a lawyer, if you want to be anything that requires school, you go to school, take yourself to school. If you need anything, if it requires school, take yourself to school. I do not shun school. I will not say fuck school. If I ever get ignorant and playing around and shit, I'll say it. But nigga, like, some people need school. I'm not about telling kids to drop out of school because if you want to be... Look, my plan A and my plan B is this. Look, when I grew up, my main things were this. I either wanted to be a UFC fighter, I wanted to be a football player, or I wanted to be a rapper. Those are the only three things that applied to me. None of those require school. None of them. None of them require school. None of them. So that's why I dropped out.
But you guys already know that X has been getting a lot of trouble with the law recently in the last few years. I spoke about him being in like the juvenile detention with Ski, and also about him being in jail and blowing up inside jail. But he was arrested and charged with robbery, assault with a deadly weapon in the summer of 2016, and arrested again in October 2016 on charges of false imprisonment, witness tampering, and aggravated battery. But he was released on bail in March of 2017. And I'm hoping that X could just like stay out of trouble, abide by his probation. I really don't want to see him back in jail again, and hope he could like prosper through this, stay out of trouble with the law. I'm hoping he could become one of the bigger artists out there in the near future. And if you guys didn't know this also, X was actually in the same jail as Kodak Black for a short period of time. But they weren't in the same cell block, but they were in the same jail itself, Broward County Jail. On the second place spot, we got X and his beef with all these people in the hip-hop community. The most notable one was with Drake, and how people accused Drake of stealing X's flow on song Look At Me. Drake refused any correlation between the two songs, but we all know, let's be real, that Drake, he stole the flow. Song KMT, I believe.
I hear da 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 my dance. I'm like, what the fuck? As soon as it started, like, I knew he was getting that. Oh, hell yeah, bro. You could take his verse. Like, they did a mashup. They put his verse on my song. My bitch don't love me no more. Ay, she kicked me out of life, bro.
Studio right in my yacht.
Well, that shit straight to the booth.
How long I been on the street?
She said one fuck, bitch, I do.
If he would have showed that he's a hospitable person, and that he's really in this shit for the culture, rather than being a fuck nigga taking my shit, running off with it, and then putting it on his album, then he would have got my kudos, he would have got my respect. I would have let him hop on the remix.
Other beef that X had was with Rob Stone, the guy that made the Chill Bill song a while ago. This all beef started when Ski Mask, the Slump God, and Rob Stone was on stage, and Ski Mask actually got cut from the lineup because of like timing issues. Ski Mask got pretty heated about this, and he refused to leave the stage. This is where the whole beef between them started, and X jumps in because X is really close friends with Ski Mask and try to defend him. And Rob Stone really wasn't feeling that, so chain of events later, he tries to get back at them.
Jump a nigga with 30 niggas and don't kill that boy. But all y'all pussy, that's fuck, all y'all. You had to jump one nigga in your own city with 30 niggas, and you ain't give that nigga the respect of a one-on-one, and you think you hard?
And after that, Rob Stone actually got cut from the Rolling Loud Fest, which is one of the biggest rap festivals out there. And this whole beef was really unnecessary, and hope they could both like move on from it, because it could damage X's reputation with like venues and all that. And this is a really bad look for both of them. It could impact their career in a really bad way. I just hope they could put the beef behind them, move on, because I see nothing good coming out of this. But he just called out recently in his XXL Freshman freestyle, he called out J. Cole, so that could possibly be the start of a beef also. He's calling out J. Cole, how he's like hypocritical. But let's just move on to the first place spot, the one you guys have all been waiting for. Definitely not an X fan if you guys don't know where his like origin of his name came from, because he has a really different name, different than any other person out there. It would only make sense if you're a fan of X to know where his name came from. He said this multiple times inside the No Jumper interview, and also the interview in No 3.5 The Beat.
All right, so XXXTentacion means unknown temptation. As far as the X, the significance of the X, for some time the X was the only unknown numeral to me. I mean, tentacion is temptation in Latin. So I actually just pushed the two together in unknown temptation, because I feel as if that's what my life revolves around.
But why three X's?
I was in boot camp, and I used to jack off a lot.
Well, that's all five facts about X that I have. All these facts came from the No Jumper interview, the Elevator interview, and also the Beat interview, the part that you just seen right there. So all credit goes to them for interviewing X. And be sure to drop the like button if you guys didn't already on this video, because I really appreciate it, because I'm pretty much making no money off this video. This video is probably not monetized, because all like the songs that I put inside this video. So that would be really appreciated if you guys subscribe to this channel. Check out future videos, and I might do other things about other rappers, like five things you didn't know about Lil Uzi or 21 Savage or Kodak, whatever you guys want, be sure to comment them down below. I might do it on like newer XXL freshmen like Carti or like Kyle or something. Honestly, your guys' choice. I'll probably do the one that's most voted up inside the comments down below. So be sure to comment who you want me to do on next. You guys probably noticed I didn't say X's full name this whole entire video because I can't pronounce it for my life. I've tried multiple times in previous videos and people just made fun of me completely, so I try to avoid it at all costs. So that's why I preferred X as X and not as his full name. I can barely speak English, let alone some Latin words, so I hope you guys do understand. And I'll see you guys later in the next King Trending video. Peace, guys.